We are going to see how shoes are made. We all know that shoes are made of leather, and that different kinds of leather are used for different kinds of shoes. Calfskin is a good kind of leather for boys' shoes. It is smooth and strong. This man has picked out enough calfskins to make 12 pairs of shoes for boys. We will see people and machines making shoes. Every shoe is made of many pieces. Here, workers are cutting out pieces from the calfskin. Watch this machine. It cuts out pieces for the upper parts of shoes. These machines cut out pieces of cloth for lining the shoes on the inside. So now we have pieces of cloth to line the shoes and leather pieces for the upper outside parts of the shoes. The pieces are now ready. The next step in making shoes is to sew the pieces of leather and the cloth linings together. They must all fit evenly, so this sharp wheel trims the edges of the leather. This worker pastes the pieces together to get them ready for sewing. These are for the sides of shoes. The sides are joined to pieces for the back. This worker pastes cloth linings on the inside of the leather. The linings will help the shoe keep its shape. Now to sew the pieces together. The sewing machine puts nice-looking stitches in the leather and makes it tight and neat. Next, this worker continues the stitching. This machine folds the edge and presses it down. And now, here is how the shoe gets holes for the shoelaces. In they go, eyelets made of metal. Here, a worker stitches the cloth linings to the tongue of the shoe. These workers are finishing the upper parts. It is looking more and more like a shoe. This stitching, as well as the other work in making shoes, needs good eyes and nimble fingers. Here is a machine that runs strings through the eyelets. Doing this helps hold the shape of the upper parts of the shoe. These are shoe lasts made of wood. Lasts for the right foot and for the left foot. These are insoles. An insole for the left shoe, an insole for the right shoe. These tacks hold the insole in place on the last. Now the upper parts meet the insoles, and the machine tacks the upper at the heel. The men at these machines shape the shoes. Claws, like fingers, pull the leather tightly over the wooden last. Tacks keep it in place. This machine drives 20 tacks at one time to fasten the upper to the back of the insole. Now a worker takes the shoes for shaping and fastening to the last around the toe. A wire holds the upper closely against the last. In this room, workers get shoes ready for putting on the thick outer soles. This machine sews a thin strip of leather called a welt to the upper part of the shoe. Now, cork paste goes under the front part of the insole. The cork will act as a cushion for the foot. The steel strips will support the arch of the foot. Here, workers add the outsoles. These are what we usually call soles. Each sole has rubber cement on it and is pressed into place. Now, the sole gets a neat trim around the edges. It takes skill and strength to do this. This machine stitches the sole to the shoe. Next, the shoes go to this machine, where rollers press the sole into shape. The shoes are now ready to be dried, and afterward, they're ready for the heels. Nails, heels. Shoe, and the heel is on. This worker sands the heels to make them smooth. This worker carefully puts ink on the edges of the soles, and then he polishes the edges. Now the lasts are no longer needed, so out they come. The actual making of the shoes is now over. Along this line, the shoes are cleaned and washed and ironed and polished. Let's watch this worker put the finishing touches on a pair of shoes. Thick shoe polish on each shoe. This soaks into the leather and leaves a clean, shiny surface when polished. Afterward, a worker sprays a dressing on the shoes. When the dressing dries, it makes a thin coat protecting the leather. At last, shoelaces go in, and the pairs of shoes look ready to wear. And now, final inspection. Everything has been done right. Well-made pairs of shoes. So, into boxes they go. Pairs of leather calfskin shoes for boys. Each shoe wrapped in tissue. And this is the way you'll find them in your shoe store when you go to buy shoes.